Boy was a true freshman.
Another Masters is in the book with a repeat winner taking home the green jacket as Scottie Scheffler has won the 2024 Masters Tournament, joining a select group of golfers who have earned the title twice in their career. Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp fell to the Charlotte Knights Sunday afternoon. Charlotte offense got things started in the second and never looked back. Up next, the Jumbo Shrimp will welcome the Norfolk Tide for a six-game set starting at 11:05 a.m. Tuesday at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. At your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, I'm Sam Nelson.
At 9:59, it is 68 degrees. Time and Ten brought to you by Bob Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
It's one chapter completed, and the next chapter is opening up. For me, you know, when I opened up that rookie contract, I was, wow, this is it. And I completed that chapter. Now it's the next chapter.
They throw low. It could be a double pass. This is Boyd. Now he wants to throw it back. And the ball picked off by the Jaguars. Josh Allen, has he done enough this year yet? He picked off the double pass and ran it back inside the 10-yard line of the Cincinnati Bengals.
Extremely honored, extremely blessed and humbled to be even given a contract of this size. And you know, I'm just so blessed.
1010XL 92.5 FM presents Jaguars Today with your hosts Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, and Dylan Denmark.
Hey, good morning, everybody, and welcome in to the 2024 Guggen Open. Tony Smith is here with me. I am Mike Dempsey. We're live at Hidden Hills.
Welcome back,
Golf
Mike.
Club. Thank you, Tony. I appreciate it.
Mm-hmm.
How are things in my absence? A lot nicer, quieter.
I hope we all had some fun, yeah.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun while I was gone.
I'm sure you did.
I must admit I missed the show on Thursday and Friday. Mm-hmm. I was a little tied up. I was out there on
the golf course. You were trying to say that you missed doing the show.
No, I didn't. I did. I really, yeah, that's what I meant, Tony. I really missed being with you. It's more just the quality time you and I spend together every morning, whether we're talking sports or not. But I got it in even on Thursday with the tornado warnings or whatever. That happened to be the one day I was getting out of town to play golf, and we had a 10 o'clock tee time in Orlando. We're like, the hell with that, we're showing up at 8.
Mm-hmm.
and they're like, yep, you can go. And we got out there and we finished 18, and the first drop started falling on us, and that was a win.
Very nice.
In and of itself.
Yeah,
baby,
it's a fun round of golf, man. When you're racing the weather and you actually get it in,
that's the thing. We didn't even feel like we were racing because we got off so early. Nobody in front of us. It was beautiful. Had a great 5 days of golf. Played 6 rounds in 5 days. Got in all but one hole because it was slow and we were getting darkness. We played 36 on Friday, or as it turned out, we played 35 on Friday. But that's all right. We had a great time, and you don't need a blow-by-blow recap. If I had made a hole-in-one, I already would have mentioned it.
Probably,
okay?
Yeah,
I did come close to hitting the stick from 160.
Yeah, I saw the picture of that one.
Yeah, I had to show Tony. Hey, have I showed you the picture yet of my newborn ball mark? All right, that's enough of that. And everyone's asking me, well, you're playing in the Guggen? You're playing in the Guggen? I'm like, oh, I need traction. Are you kidding me? 6 rounds in 5. I don't think I've ever played that much in that shorter period of time. You know, I realized as I woke up this morning, I'm 55 years old. Total. I'm not 25 anymore. So
I, on a vacation once with my dad, I played 6 rounds in 3 days.
Woo!
Yeah.
That's getting it done. But you were a younger man, I'm sure.
That was a lot of golf.
Right?
Yeah.
I did do 3 rounds in 1 day.
It was also the first time I broke 90.
Oh.
Was that day.
How about that?
Yeah.
Maybe you just need a good warm-up.
Yeah, I wasn't sure where I was as far as the total score. I chipped in on 18, and my dad's like, you just shot an 89.
Nice.
You know, I was like, oh, like I thought that it was close, but I wasn't sure exactly where it was. Yeah, it's the first time I broke 90.
I don't know if anyone's breaking a personal best out of here today at the Guggen Open, but you can hear in the background a womp, 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 a very important golf announcement, Tony.
Yes.
Which basically consists of get to your cart, hit the ball, we'll post the score, and we'll have a few beers and hamburgers later. And
have a good time, everybody.
Have a good time. That's what this is all about. We are up on YouTube, even though we're on the road. You and I don't go on the road very often.
Ever.
We're homebodies is what we are. But we are on the road. See me drinking my tasty beverage this morning. But if we were to pan the camera just this way to my left, you'd see all the carts lined up, ready to go. Hidden Hills, beautiful facility. So we'll be out here. What was, you know, I got to experience one day of the joy of Josh Allen remaining with the Jaguars and giving you hope that maybe he can be a lifetime Jag down the road. I mean, so many things can happen. Even the great sometimes spend a year or two at the end of their career, a la Fred Taylor with another team. And if that happens, so be it. Josh Allen, I think in his heart, will be a Jag for life, no matter how it ultimately ends up. And that's fantastic. What was the general tenor of the fan base on Thursday and Friday as that news got to kind of settle in?
Yeah, I think Thursday, a lot of what we were trying to do on the show was still reacting to what Josh had to say, right, on Wednesday, because all that happened after we got done was Wednesday afternoon. He met with the media, you know, so we got to react to everything he had to say. And we actually made it our question of the day on Thursday was, look, Josh Allen's not ducking away from what he's got at the top of his list as far as what he wants
to be great.
Like he's talking
great.
I want to be league MVP on defense. I want to win a Super Bowl and be the MVP of that game. Like he's setting the goals really, really high. So, you know, we asked on Thursday, what do you believe Josh Allen's legacy will wind up being in Jacksonville? It's hard to imagine that he's not going to wind up as the best defensive player in franchise history.
At the time of his retirement.
Right.
Yeah, sure.
You know,
barring some kind of something unforeseen, right?
Right. And as we said on Thursday, I didn't feel like anything Josh had to say on Wednesday, talking about defense's MVP, which he was in the conversation for, you know, last year.
Should have been probably a little bit more than he was, but so be it.
Super Bowl MVP. I think he's a talented enough guy to achieve everything he's put out there as a goal. Not that I don't think a lot of that isn't the far end of what you can expect out of a player, right? Like it's at the very top of a list you're going to make of those kind of things. But I think Josh Allen is a talented enough player that whatever goals like that he sets for himself, he's capable of achieving at least.
Well, I think the big thing with him, and I don't think we've questioned this with him, is that I don't think this changes his preparation and his want to and his drive. And you can say all these things, but if you're not putting in the work to take every step to it's not just, hey, I want to be a Hall of Famer, I want to be a Pro Bowler. What are the steps that you need to day, and what are you going to do that you have to build on for tomorrow and on down the line? Is that me, by the way? I'm having all kinds of phone issues. No, you know what's going on with my phone? My phone will ring now, and I'll hear it ring, and, like, nothing pops up with, like, to hit the green button to accept
Phantom
this
ring,
call.
Yeah.
Right? But it's ringing, and I'll pull down the top and, you know, whatever the case, you know, and nothing's there, so I have to wait until the call ends and I get a missed call and I know who was calling me. It's kind of weird. Anyway, we're at the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open this morning. Appreciate Coastal Equipment. They've been a great title sponsor of this event for a while and one of the best sponsors we've got on 1010 XL 92.5 FM, and tons of folks out here from the 1010 XL family getting ready to take part in a day of a little mild debauchery,
yeah,
I would imagine.
Yeah.
Mild debauchery.
Have a good time. You're
Have
playing
a good time.
Golf. You brought some friends. Enjoy the sunshine. Hit them as straight as you can hit them and enjoy whatever the process is.
If you can't hit them straight, hit them far.
Yeah.
At the very least, swing hard, for God's sakes here, man.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what the – I think it's everybody's playing their own ball.
I don't know.
Which, you know.
I can hear that announcements are going on, but I'm not listening to the announcements. Well, I'm sure they're letting them know all that information.
That is not our grave concern today. My concern is what's up with Pockets. Dylan Denmark, have you missed me since last we've been face-to-face?
A little bit. Just a little bit.
That's lukewarm at best, young man. I missed you greatly, I'll have you know. I thought about you every day.
And there they go.
And, they're off. So things will quiet down around these parts here. So hopefully everybody hits them long and straight today and makes all the putts that they look at. Pockets, how did the track excursions go when I was gone?
We did good Wednesday. We did our thing, and we got another one tonight. And track don't stop, man.
I know. It runs on and on and on and on. All right, so, Tone, we're 10 days out from the NFL draft.
Mm-hmm.
Fired up about that, and just we'll see what comes down the line. But we are at Hidden Hills today, so we're looking at this roster for the Jacksonville Jaguars, and we thought we'd tie it in a little bit with the Guggen Open and something maybe not as obvious as we might ask. But we're asking today, what will be a hidden strength for this football team. In other words, you know, hidden is a subjective word, right? Mm-hmm. It's just something that we don't talk about. And it's interesting. I guess we could ask, what do we think will be the non-hidden strengths of this football team as well, right? I mean, we don't know about the offensive line. The wide receiver core is somewhat in flux because we don't know what they're going to add to it. If they will add to it something significant, you did lose Calvin Ridley, and Gabe Davis is here, even though he's not a direct one-for-one replacement. That's mm-hmm. where you're at. Tight end, probably a strength with Evan Engram. You know, will running back be a strength? I wouldn't say it was last year, you know, and part of that is the offensive line. Pass rush, well, your top two guys.
Yeah.
Right. I mean, so on and on you go, and you start to go, well, what, as you rank the obvious strengths of this team, I think it's a good football team.
Yeah.
But I don't look at it and go, well, we're necessarily the best in the league at this, and
right.
you know, this is the area, and this is our identity. I think they want to be a Trevor Lawrence centric identity.
I would think so,
right, on offense. But what will that mean, and what will that translate to, and what weapons will we have available to him? We don't know the full complement right now.
No, and it's part of what makes, you know, we've talked about the draft obviously a lot, you know, over the last few months. But it's part of what makes whatever the Jags are going to do in the first couple rounds of the draft so interesting, because there are so many spots where you can circle and say, yeah, you know, them drafting that position makes sense. Because I do think, I agree with you, I think the football team's pretty good going into this offseason, doing what they've already done in free agency and now getting ready for the draft here in a week and a half. But there are areas where they could certainly look to improve. Right. And it does feel like a football team in light of the question that we're asking today of what is, you know, if you're going to circle one position group as that's the one, right? Like, it does feel like that's a little bit more difficult. Last year we asked this question, I think everyone answers wide receiver. Right.
Yeah.
You know, Calvin Ridley being
what'll
here,
be the strength of this football team.
Right.
Yes.
You know, I think everyone would have come back with that kind of
we
answer.
We thought, you know, top 10 group in the league may be better, right, depending on if they all play up to their capabilities.
This year it's way more wide open.
And that was Zay coming off the best season of his career.
Yes.
He was healthy at the time, you know. So, you know, look, injuries can derail, but, you know, I wouldn't say they played like the necessarily a top 10
no.
receiver group last year anyway. So today, go beyond the maybe not so obvious strengths of this team
sure.
and try to figure out what will be a hidden strength of this football team, at least something that we haven't talked about on a regular basis as being a likelihood to be something that the Jags can hang their hat on as the season goes along. If you want to hit us up with your responses to that or talk any aspect of Jaguar football as we're 10 days out from the NFL draft, you can pick up the phone and call us on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines at 641-1010. Same number for the text line, designed by Lifetime Enclosures. Get in that YouTube chat if you're watching on the 1010XL YouTube channel. If you are, I just waved right at you right there, and you'll see that probably. I'm guessing there's a little bit of a delay on the YouTube stream is my guess. Or you can hit us up on Twitter or X at MD_1010XL, at 1010XL Fat Tony, and at 1010XL Denmark.
Ain't no laws when you're drinking claws, baby.
I saw some White Claws. See, that's the thing, Pockets. I was in public, saw some White Claw. You know, I'm like, that's Dylan right there, man. I do think of you all the darn time. All right, we'll come back, and let's get into something I heard the drill discussing this morning that Jeff Prosser said he would not be in favor of when it comes to the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Okay.
We'll tell you what that was, and we'll get our thoughts on that coming up on the other side. We are live at Hidden Hills, the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open for 2024, off and rolling right now. It's too late now. You've already hit your first shot, all right? That dream round, you've already probably lost the dream. I know that's how it usually goes for me. That first tee shot on one, and it's all downhill from there. All right, away we go. Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith live at Hidden Hills for the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open. Dylan Denmark back at World Headquarters. You're listening to Jaguars Today. Keep it right here on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today Monday
on 1010XL
is brought to you by Ratify Credit Union, your neighborhood credit union.
From the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios.
JOI, where the pros go. She's the gem of your ride home.
You've got something everybody wants. You've got talent, girl.
Lauren Brooks.
And I'm not just saying that.
On Helmets and Heels from noon to 2.
If you want to rock, You got to break the rules.
On 1010XL.
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Well, I tell you, if I needed any reinforcement as to whether Awaken 180 works, all I needed to do was show up here at the Guggen Open today, and I got it. A lot of people say, man, you look great. You look like you dropped a lot of weight. Well, I have, and the key is I've been able to keep that weight loss intact thanks to the plan from Awaken 180 Weight Loss. It's not just losing weight. I've lost weight in the past. I've lost big chunks of weight. I've always found it again rather quickly, but not this time with Awaken 180, who promises you're going to be able to lose 4 to 5 pounds a week on average, but then after that, you're going to be able to maintain that like you've never done before. If you've had problems not necessarily losing the weight but keeping it off, Awaken 180 Weight Loss is the program for you. It's not a crash diet. It's not a bunch of pills that you're popping. It's a different philosophy. It's a different way of looking at how you eat and what you eat and when you eat. Give them a call at 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. You can become the next Awaken 180 Weight Loss success story. Go online to awaken180weightloss.com.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference.
Let's go! Looking for a night of action without a big hit to your bankroll? This Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, cheer on your Sharks as they go all in against the Las Vegas Nighthawks. See what I did there? With tickets as low as $15, you can't find this kind of family, affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com.
Let's go!
Decades night. Find that old members-only jacket or favorite flannel shirt. We're celebrating the 90s. What's your favorite decade?
Let's go!
Don't miss the fun this Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. For tickets, call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. That's tickets at 904-621-0700.
Let's go! Let's go!
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Pick and hear, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. From dry eyes and allergies causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, about nigh can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit aboutnigh.com to schedule your consultation. About nigh and Associates, keeping the First Coast focused.
My son and I just built a rabbit hutch for two bunnies he got the girls for Easter. That gives them a dog, three cats, a snake, a gecko, and two bunnies. At Zures, we love pets. If you are a pet lover and need some help cleaning up after those furry friends, give Zures a call. For April, Zures is offering 25% off on all floor cleaning services. That's 25% off the cleaning of your carpets, tile and grout, vinyl and wood floors, and your area rugs. Zures, spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean. Zures.
Want to pay less to vacation more? General RV makes that possible and even more affordable during the model year closeout, April 17th through the 21st. 5 days of savings and free family activities with the best deals on travel trailers, motorhomes, fifth wheels, and more. Guaranteed. Get to the model year closeout where you can pay less to vacation more just how you want it. Only at General RV in Orange Park on Wells Road off 295.
You know, people ask me all the time, Mia, why buy from Arlington Toyota? And when they do, here's what I tell them. Let's start with peace of mind. When you buy any new Toyota from Arlington, their lifetime warranty goes with you. That's unlimited time and miles. Plus, you get 30 days to love your pre-owned purchase or exchange it for one that you do. And you even get a complimentary car wash with your service visit. Now you know why you should buy from Arlington. 10939 Atlantic Boulevard and online at arlingtontoyota.com.
It's all about the tales of the tide and the thrill of the hunt.
Wilderness and water awaits. There's nothing like the great outdoors.
On the Nimnet Outdoors Show, presented by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing and Septic Services.
Every Saturday morning, 7 to 10.
On 1010XL.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Chose Safer CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Jaguars Today on 1010XL.
So, Tony,
I tried
to push it.
I go, hey, you guys got some Pro-Vs down there, like burning the hole in your pocket?
Yeah.
And
sure enough,
fine salesman from 1010XL, Greg comes up with a sleeve of, like, literally hands me a sleeve of Pro-V1s.
Uh-huh.
I said, hey, you got some of those loose $100 bills down there.
Yeah.
Didn't have those available down at the end at the table. But
still got the sleeve of Pro V1s.
I got a sleeve of Pro V1s, brother. I feel like a winner.
Uh-huh. Mike, you missed
big
it.
Time.
You missed it Thursday, man. We had boxes of them in here, boys.
What?
Boxes.
Did you get your greedy paws on those?
No, I didn't get any. I was a dummy.
Did Ken Brady or Jack O'Brien say, no, we got to have those for the actual game?
Yeah, we had to put these in little baggies for them.
They don't know what's going to be in those baggies. Were they promised Pro V1s? Anyway, man, I guess I did miss out pockets. But what can you say? That's better late than never. By the way, tune in right now to the 1010XL YouTube channel. Tony rocking a little bedhead this morning,
man. Oh, I
man.
Do, yeah,
he
for
really
sure.
Did.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
it's a bedhead day.
Like, yeah, late getting out of bed this morning, man. All right, so let's get down to it. I remembered for once what I wanted to talk about here. I heard Jeff Prosser on the way in talking with Dan on the drill about the idea of what, you know, obviously what the Jags might do at 17, and that's been a huge topic of conversation.
No doubt. Yeah.
So one thing he doesn't want to see him do, Tony, is trade back. And I understand what he was saying. He's like, look, I feel like we need to get the single best player possible here. The 17th best player, or in you may look at it and like say the 13th or 12th best player, depending mm-hmm. on how many quarterbacks go, at least of the players we're interested in, okay, as opposed to say the 28th if we trade down towards the end of the first round, whatever the case may be. And look, I get that, but how confident are we that whether it's Balky or anybody else that we know exactly who that 17th guy is? Now, granted, if there's a guy you love, you're probably going to stay there and take him.
You're
right?
Going to pick him.
Right. If it's Terrion Arnold or Quinyon Mitchell, one of these top corners that we talked about, maybe if it's Brian Thomas, maybe somebody else. But, Tone, looking at a couple of mock drafts today, mm-hmm. and we've done this exercise. You go, okay, here's who the Jags take at 17. What would you have thought about, like, the next eight picks? And pretty much, like, six out of every mock draft's next eight picks, I'd be happy with that guy, too.
Sure.
And this is the thing. Last year, you trade back – one single spot with the Giants, right? One spot, they come up, they take Deontay Banks. You were obviously focusing in on getting Anton Harrison at the time. Now, the Bills mm-hmm. would come to you and make you a second trade offer, and you'd pick up more draft capital.
Yeah.
But the two picks that they got for moving one single spot with the Giants turned into Derek Parrish. Okay. It's a bust. Wasn't worth anything.
No.
Okay. The other one's Antonio Johnson.
Right.
He's one of your starters this year. So you move back a single spot, and you picked up a guy that with a pick that you wouldn't have otherwise had. And maybe you just took a flyer. Maybe you just said, you know what, Antonio Johnson, rated too highly in the process. For whatever reason, he's fallen. We're just going to take him here. Okay, but you had that extra couple of picks. Yeah, Derek Parrish didn't work out. Are you kidding me? If you go 50-50 on your fifth, sixth, seventh round picks, it was a fifth and a seventh. I mean, like, I just think we're in a –
trade down rich environment with this football team?
I would think so. I think it's going to be more difficult to figure out what a trade back will look like in this year's draft. I do, looking at the needs of all the teams even around the Jaguars, right? I don't think the Jags are unique in going into this draft in the position where they're drafting, you know, somewhere in that middle part of the draft. Mm-hmm. I don't think they're unique in that position where they have corner and wide receiver and offensive line. Like, I think a bunch of teams that are drafting in the same kind of area as the Jaguars have the same positions circled, right, in this year's draft. That doesn't mean that it's impossible to figure out how to get a trade partner to move down a little bit in this year's draft, but I do think it'll be more difficult given how common the needs are.
Well, it may be more difficult to get them to move up.
Right.
Right.
Like it's hard to convince somebody to come up and give you those couple extra picks. It's not impossible, right? Like, there are players that might be good enough to entice someone to make a move. I was doing a mock draft on Friday up in the Pittsburgh area.
Okay.
Right? And, you know, they've been doing the mock for a couple of weeks now. So I'm picking 17, 16, and come off the board right before I went on. And they let me know what had been going on with the board to give people an idea. The top two corners were gone, the guys that we've talked about so much. Alt, Fashanu, Fa'atanu, gone.
Okay.
On the offensive line, Bowers picked, Murphy picked, who is a name we heard a lot on Friday. Thomas Jr. had been selected in the first 16 picks of the draft. So I put out, you know, a one-hour, let me know how you feel about the options we have available to us here. And the names I included in there were Talese Fuaga, Jared Verse, Latu, and your preferred cornerback of the ones that were remaining. And thinking through that scenario specifically, I thought, one, I'm going to go with Verse here, I think. Right? That's what I wound up doing. I was debating between him and Latu because I do they're close in my mind, right, those two prospects. But I wound up going with Verse. But I do think that specific scenario is the one where you're likely more likely to find somebody that's willing to make a trade up to get one of those defensive ends, right, before they're both gone. I could see some team making a small move to go up there and get that done. But if there is going to be a run on offensive line and a run on corner, which would only take two to really be a run right on corner before the Jags are picking, I think it makes it really difficult to envision how they're going to be able to make a move back.
Yeah, no, it may be. I'm just talking more about my willingness to do it if
it
presents
itself. I'm willing
itself.
To do it, too.
You know what I mean? That's and, like, by the way, out of that group, I'd probably go in Talese Fuaga is my guy because I think
I get it.
I think he is as unlikely to fall to 17 as Verse is, meaning there's a range where I could see either one of them possibly being there. Like,
yeah.
That doesn't make a whole lot of sense, especially based on recent projections, which, by the way, doesn't mean the projections are right. We get caught up in
we have
mock
idea how teams
saying,
feel about any of this.
Right. You know, sometimes you get a little sense, right? But you see oftentimes Talese Fuaga mock in the top 10, 11 picks, and you're like, you start to feel like, okay, that's where he's going to go. And that's not necessarily the case. You know, I look last year, look at the Giants, though. Okay, the Giants are sitting there at the time. It was, I think, the Jags had 24, the Giants are at 25, and they wanted to move up to one spot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now, granted, you got to like a guy more than another guy, but they wanted to get Deontay Banks. Okay?
Yep.
Well, Joey Porter, no other corners ended up going in the first round. So maybe they just felt that way about Banks compared to Porter, right?
Sure.
But a lot of people love Porter and had him as a first rounder as well.
Yep.
And the Giants could have sat there alone at 25, knowing A, the Jags might not go corner. Okay. B, if the Jags go corner, maybe they take Porter, mm-hmm. right? If we want Banks, maybe they go a different position entirely. Okay. So these are all possible.
Yeah, that's the Etienne Najee Harris thing.
Correct.
Right? Like Pittsburgh's right in front of them. Maybe they're going to go running back. They do, and the Jags go, yay.
Right. You didn't take the one we wanted.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
And so maybe it goes that way. But knowing that their worst-case scenario was Deontay Banks is gone, Joey Porter's available to them. And they're very similar in terms of, like, their build and their length and all this. They opted to spend a fifth and a seventh round pick to move one spot. And you just don't know when that's going to happen, right? Because everyone's board is a little bit different. So, you know, we look at it and go, well, who's going to make that move for so – I don't know. I have no idea. I don't know what's on Buffalo's mind. Do they love Adonai Mitchell much more than Xavier Leggett or whoever else might be available at wide receiver. You know, every team might have a different guy that they feel that way about. Like, this is the one special one that we can't let get away. So, again, it's not, I agree with you that it may not be a great environment because a lot of teams might be sitting there saying, hey, for the same thing, if I miss out on so-and-so, I'm very happy with X.
You know, looking at it from – and I agree that, look, I'm willing to move from 17. I'm willing to move back if the right offer is being made there. Is there a player – you know, you just mentioned Fuanga, right? But if, say, Fuanga was available there at 17, is that a player that is high caliber enough that you're like, I don't need to hear the offers necessarily? I would listen to whatever offer.
I'm
going to
listen
to
every offer, right? Always.
But is there a player where the offer would maybe have to be over the top for you to say yes?
I mean, it might be one of those lines. Again, for me, I can't sit there and tell you that I'm basing this off what others are saying about Tali Fuanga, right?
Sure.
So I'm not going to go and tell you that he is without a doubt, because based on my years of scouting offensive linemen, I can't pass on this guy. But if they feel that way about one of those guys, for me, you know, I don't know. I don't know how they feel Brian Thomas would fit. Like, Brian Thomas is not a guy I have to have there. If it's one of those two top corners, I feel really conflicted about moving out of that spot. If I have the chance to take one and not mess with it and get a guy that I think can walk in and earn a starting job right away at that spot and be potentially an elite player at the position, because you're probably going to get, in that scenario, you're getting probably one of the top two corners in the draft.
Mm-hmm.
And that's rare at 17, usually.
Yeah, I do think, you know, from the outside, we can look at it and say, because I'm with you. Like, I do have the top two corners kind of grouped together in my mind, right? Like, I don't feel like this is the better one and this is the lesser one.
I would take Mitchell, but I don't – that's based on a hunch more than anything else.
And so it's more – if both those corners are still on the board there and someone wants to make me an offer to me to move one spot,
okay, sure.
You know, but I'm not the Jaguars.
Right.
Right? And I don't know what their evaluation of those players would be. Would Jared Verse – how close is Jared Verse to – being in that same kind of Fuanga mindset
he's
of
not
I'm not
for
willing
me.
To move.
He's okay. not for me simply because I'm conflicted about taking a guy that is not going to start.
Mm-hmm.
You know, or at least doesn't have an obvious road to a starting job really in the near future, right? As long as we don't see any kind of massive backsliding by Trayvon Walker or a permanent move to defensive tackle, which I don't get the sense is coming. I don't know. Maybe they are sitting there going, boy, Jared Verse is never going to get to us. But if he does, watch how quick we turn this card in. And that may be the case. And if that's it, I'm fine with it, right? Mm-hmm. Like, I am. Like, I get him. I get the idea of him.
But he's
as
not
a
on the list I'm not willing to move.
Not
because
for
he's
me.
Okay.
In fact, he may be the bait that gets the offer that entices you. Now, again, I'm not necessarily moving for a fifth and a seventh. The Jags did it last year because I think they felt like, well, we're going to get the guy we want anyway.
Yeah.
Why don't we pick up some extra capital? So in that case, they had a specific guy that they didn't want to miss out on. This year, I think, is different. Maybe they have a specific guy, but I think it might just be a case where they have a large pool of guys that they're like me. I look at these mocks.
I'd be surprised if they didn't have a big pool this year.
I would think, right? Yeah. And they're still going to prioritize them in order. And still, if we're here at 17, we're going to take this one because he's the top-rated guy. And we don't like this guy we get at 25 as much. But we don't like him that much less. And when you consider we're going to get a third rounder and a fifth or whatever, you know, in addition to that, and then maybe use some of that capital to move back up. And I know there are people listening and go, well, Balky was unable to move up. Well, that was last year, right? You got to have both sides. I don't think people are out there throwing up the Balky wall going, we're not going to deal with Trent Balky. I think they're saying, no, in those positions, when you try to make those moves, we also coveted a guy
we like
who was coming
too.
To it.
Yeah.
Right. We have the right to prioritize our board the way we want to. So anyway, I just hearing that coming in, I was a little bit surprised because I feel like it's such a rich, you know, kind of range where they're going to be falling. As a matter of fact, we'll look at latest offerings from both NFL.com and CBS when we come back a little bit and get an idea of those players that are falling in that range. Right now, live, though, out at Hidden Hills, the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open is underway. There's already been some cursing, I'm guessing. There's already been copious alcoholic beverages because everyone's got a designated driver, which is great. Mm-hmm. There's been fun and mayhem and probably even a
few
birdies.
There's been the overconfidence of having just watched the Masters for a week.
Doesn't it do it to you, though? Like, yeah, bro, it's the same. You watch the Masters, you watch TPC, you watch these big tournaments.
This looks easy.
And you're like, oh, now that's what the swing looks like, right? Oh, I can see that. I can see that. That's going to be me. Now, by the way, I was having the biggest problem on Saturday trying to say Oberg, Højgaard, and Homa all in a row. And so then in my head I said, Oberg, Højgaard, and Homa walk into a bar. And that's how slow I had to say it, right? Like I was trying to say that three times fast, and it was not working out for your boy. So anyway, but yes, you're absolutely right. You watch that, it's like anything. You think, oh, man, it's puts me in the mood, and I'm going to go out there and execute now. If I had a putt that ran 59 on the stimp meter, I'd be able to make it.
Watch this.
I watched them do it at the Masters. All right, we'll come back. We are live. The Coastal Equipment Guggen Open out at Hidden Hills. Jaguars Today rolls on. We'll be out here with all of our shows live all day long, of course, with Helmets and Heels, XL Primetime, and the Frangie Show to follow as the festivities continue throughout the morning and into the afternoon. Mike Dempsey and Tony Smith here live at Hidden Hills. Dylan Denmark back at World Headquarters. This is Jaguars Today on 1010 XL and 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today.
Jaguars Today.
From the JOI Studios at 1010 XL.
Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute.
Where the pros go.
Hello, you're on the air.
1010 XL has a new lineup.
Lunch. Here we go.
Dan Hicken and Jeff Prosser.
Mornings.
Mike Dempsey and Fat Tony.
10 to noon.
Mia O'Brien. Lauren Brooks and Taylor Dahl.
Noon to 2.
Josie, Matt Hayes and Leon.
2 to 4.
Frank Frangie and Hayes Carline.
4 to 6.
And Baloo and Hacker in the evening.
Flip a dial. Instant entertainment.
Hayes Carline here. Tired of missing out on the conversation due to hearing loss? At Jacksonville Hearing and Balance, their team of audiologists led by Dr. Douglas Green can help you rediscover the joy of connection. Visit jhbi.org today.
ET here, and it's time for the Taste of Golf at TPC Sawgrass, April 24th. Join me for fine cuisine from chefs from the top golf clubs in our area, craft cocktails, games, and unique auction items. This is one of the most charitable events in our area. Come network with a sophisticated audience who is passionate about golf and its values, all while impacting the youth in our community. All proceeds benefit First Tee North Florida. For tickets, go to tasteofgolf.com. Come on, somebody.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. Right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement. Plus, no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC1258484.
UniversalRoof.com.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified, and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket, with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit ua234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time, in fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th, bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena.
Guns and Hoses.
On the field, he brought the boom.
I'll always be a linebacker at heart.
He brings that attitude to the microphone.
I'm Jaguars Today's middle linebacker, Kyle McMahon.
Friday from 10 to noon, brought to you by Renewal by Anderson Windows and Doors on 1010XL.
Beards Diamond's most popular sale is back.
All wedding bands are buy one, get one free.
Plus, all stackables, all right-hand rings, all eternity bands, and more are buy one, get one free.
At the St. John's Town Center or at Beards Diamonds.
Mia here with a shout out to all property owners looking to spruce up your spaces for the spring.
Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a crystal clear shine, and ensure your gutters flow freely. Whether you own a home or business, Window Gang will transform your outdoor space. Call 262-7300 for a free estimate. Don't wait. Let Window Gang bring the sparkle back to your property today. That's 262-7300.
Rick Ballew for Carlson Dental. You know, I've been telling you this for quite some time because it's true. I hate going to the dentist, or at least I used to hate going to the dentist. I had total anxiety. And then I tried sedation, light sedation for cleaning and deep sedation as well for cavities and root canals. Folks, it's an incredible experience. So don't be nervous. Don't be scared. Go to CarlsonDentalGroup.com. That's CarlsonDentalGroup.com for all of your dental needs.
Elevate your party game to the next level with Mystic Cornhole Company. Visit their showroom now on the corner of Hogan and Parental Home Road. It's your one-stop destination for all things cornhole. MysticCornhole.com.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free from credit cards, car loans, and personal loans. Hey, Prosser here. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards. Get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508, 904-999-1508, or go to loanpronto.com. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
1010XL is presented by Farrah and Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Now, more Jaguars today on 1010XL.
All right, what is up with the Jags that they're teasing about the logo, old school logo coming back? They're just basically saying it's coming back. Something
they're
with
gonna
the
wear
logo
throwbacks.
Is coming.
Yeah. Some manner. At some point this year, they're going to be wearing throwbacks of some sort that's going to have the full Jaguar logo.
Does
which
that
was
mean
very early on? I think that was just for the first couple of years that they had the full Jaguar on it.
On the jersey.
Yeah.
Right. They were going to have it, I think, on the helmet, but they can't. They don't have. It was too. The logo they had was too similar to like Jaguar.
Yeah.
Motor cars or whatever the case. So
yeah. I don't know what exactly that's going to look like.
Right,
we
don't know.
Like the new Jaguar logo is awesome. Like the logo on the helmet is awesome.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
Compared to that, the old Jaguar head, but yeah. Everyone loves the leaping.
But if
Jaguar.
They got, I mean, fans, what they're clamoring for is that old fashioned
97 uniform.
They
right.
want those uniforms. Yeah. They want to see the players wearing the uniforms that Jimmy and Fred wore.
Yes.
I mean, that's what everyone wants to see this year, and hopefully that's what throwbacks mean.
Well.
But it's officially, it's hard to tell.
There was that rumor like a week or two ago that there'll be among a handful of clubs wearing throwback or alternate helmets.
Yeah.
So, don't know officially, being a little cryptic about things, but we'll keep our eye on that one as it comes down the line. So, I know that does excite some people. I'm not huge into the whole uniform thing, but I do appreciate those 90s looks for sure.
Yeah.
We saw Devontae Smith just got paid by the Philadelphia Eagles, according to Adam Schefter. 3 years, $75 million, $51 million guaranteed. So basically, yes. 2 years are guaranteed, is what it sounds like out of the three.
Yeah.
Or close to it. So you're now, you can be a number two receiver on a team. Seriously, right? Make it $25 million a year on average. And he's, to me, definitely the number two behind A.J. Brown. He's really good. He'd be number one on a lot of teams, but he's not on a lot of teams. He's on the
and where he got drafted in the Heisman and all that tells you, yeah, like he is that type of guy, but he's on a team where the number one spot is.
Got another guy, right. Yeah. But he's getting paid, you know, he's not getting paid Tyreek Hill money, but he's not Tyreek Hill either.
Yeah.
So, and he's not Jamar Chase and he's not Justin Jefferson. He's really good. He's not super elite, in my opinion, but. There you go. That's the going rate for a really good number two guy
right now. It's tough to keep the band together, Tone. You know, I mean, it is, right? T. Higgins understands he's not going to get traded, but he probably also understands he's not going to get a long-term deal with the Cincinnati Bengals because they've got to pay Ja'Marr Chase, and Joe Burrow's already got that. You can't pay everyone top-of-the-market money. Now, could you pay three guys? Yes, but are you going to pay your quarterback and his top two receivers that? You might. I get you can, depending on who else you have to pay, but there are limits eventually. You know, reporting is now that rumors, Brandon Ayuk has requested a trade from the San Francisco 49ers. His agent says, check your sources, bub, which is, you know, or you need better sources. Was that what it was?
Something
like that, right? Yeah. Now, because it was sources say, well, you need better sources, which, by the way, is not an official denial, right? No. It's not saying, no, we did not. You need better sources. It's just you need better sources.
Yeah, you need better sources.
I never said he didn't request a trade from the 49ers. I mean, that's what he's trying to imply.
You need better sources. Brandon needs more money.
Right. You need better sources, but, yeah, we're also expecting to get paid a lot more than we're currently.
It's not a complete denial. And the last time we heard from the 49ers, they were saying, look, we're not trading him. We're trying to work out a deal with him.
Right.
Right? Like,
but
that's
Mia,
the way
our
they
own Mia O'Brien
about it.
Also reported that there were, like, there was at least, had to have been some talk because there was a price put on Brandon Ayuk for the Jaguars of the 17th pick plus Zay Jones.
It's out there. Despite what everyone involved in it is saying, that it was at least out there that Brandon Ayuk could be traded.
And it may be, right. Look, he may have said something to the effect of, man, if y'all aren't going to take care of me, you know, you might as well deal me.
Trade me
right?
or pay me.
Right, which isn't quite the same as I'm formally requesting a trade from this organization. At least I don't take it that way. There's a little bit of semantics involved. Clearly he's not happy with the situation, and clearly he wants to wear those old 90s Jaguar throwback uniforms if he gets the opportunity. And we'd like to give him that opportunity, and that would solve that. Can we give you our first next year for Brandon Ayuk? I'm going to say they won't take it.
Probably not.
I'd do that right now, though, Tone. You know, and there's risk in that, too, because if you're like, your quarterback gets hurt and your season goes down the tubes and you're picking ninth next year, all of a sudden you don't have that first-round pick, but you do have Brandon Ayuk, right? So you got to give something to get something. I get that, but with the, you know, I've said it with the holes they have. I greatly prefer not to give up 17 in any deal. Second-rounder and something next year? All right, let's talk.
Yeah.
You know, he plugs a hole, and he plugs a hole at a pretty high level.
Yeah.
If you go that route.
I mean, there is real risk there. Carolina is paying that risk right now. You know, they were willing to make a deal last year to go get a quarterback when everyone was talking about next year's quarterback class is the class.
Right.
Right? Like, that was the conversation going into it last year. They made the move, and they were in position to pick first.
God, you think about that.
But they didn't have a pick.
How colossally botched that looks right now. Right now, granted, look, the Jags were picking first the year if they took Trevor Lawrence, right?
They did.
So people are going, what are you talking about, man? You're blind. Well,
but they didn't give it away.
They didn't. And I also watched Bryce Young last year, and I think without a halo clean pocket, you know, don't know if this guy has the ability, if bodies are buzzing around him, to drive the ball with a lot of traffic.
Right. Like, it was a eye-opening enough rookie year for Bryce that if they had drafted him last year and still had the number one overall pick this year, there'd be serious conversation about whether Carolina should go quarterback again this year.
If they still had that pick. Right.
Like, if they were still picking number one, people would be like, well,
like,
how do you pass
you can get
up
Caleb Williams right now. Yeah. Exactly. Oh, no, you got to support Bryce with Marvin Harrison Jr. Oh, right. Now I'm going to get Caleb.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to go that route.
That's how uninspiring the rookie year was for Bryce.
Right, and in that scenario, they'd still had DJ Moore and a bunch of other picks on top of that, but that's not the way it went for him. Let's take a look at some of the latest mocks out there, Tony. We had some trades in the latest one involving the Jacksonville Jaguars. They don't give you the full trade details on all this stuff, but Gennaro Filippo over at NFL.com. Or, I'm sorry. Gennaro Felice, not to be confused with Gennaro Filippo, because that's the guy I usually go to for my draft insight. But he is the deputy editor of written content at NFL.com.
Okay.
So, fine. But anyway, he did a mock where he had the Jags making a move up the board. Here's how the first dozen or so picks went. Caleb Williams, no great surprise. Quarterback out of USC goes to Chicago. Commanders take Drake May in this draft scenario, and the Patriots take Jaden Daniels. So that's the order the quarterbacks go there. Marvin Harrison Jr., the wide receiver out of Ohio State, to Arizona. And then J.J. McCarthy to the Vikings on a trade up to the Chargers spot.
There's a lot of that going on.
What, the
Vikings specifically trading up to five.
Yeah. I mean, look, if you're Arizona, if Arizona's going to stick and pick and nobody else is moving in that spot, then if you're Minnesota, you're fine with that, right? If McCarthy is your guy, does Harbaugh try to squeeze a little extra out because, oh, it's McCarthy, he's the best player in the draft, Tone? I don't know. Not our concern. As long as we get as many quarterbacks as we can in the top 16. Malik Nabers here, the LSU wide receiver to the Giants. Roma Dunze goes to the Jets on a trade-up. Right? They trade up with Tennessee, which I don't love because then Tennessee's going to slide back at pretty much about the same player they would have got anyway and get extra draft capital.
Yep.
Dallas Turner, the edge rusher at Alabama, goes to the Falcons. Joe Alt goes to the Bears, so not so fast, Tennessee. You're not going to get him. Tennessee then goes Brock Bowers.
Interesting.
Kind of weird kind of deal, right? Like, you've got all those offensive linemen staring you in the face. If they sit at seven, I don't know a single mock that doesn't have them taking an offensive tackle. And you got your choice of all but one in the entire draft.
Okay.
And you go Brock Bowers. I'm not sure I believe that. He said, by the way, I'm full disclosure, I'm hell-bent on Bowers being a top 10 pick one way or another. Well, then you're trying to shoehorn him in to your draft.
It didn't happen in the first nine. I got one spot left here to this team that maybe not needing him as bad as some others, but okay.
So the Chargers traded back to 11. They take J.C. Latham. So Denver's on the clock, and the Jags move up the board. As they put it, Jags fly up the board. Well, all right, they moved up five spots.
Jaguars don't fly.
Right. We ran. We pounced. We leapt. Mm-hmm. Notably, leapfrogging the cornerback needy Raiders to get their pick of the cornerback litter. Yes, it's the senior cover man out of Toledo, and no, it isn't surprising. Quinyon Mitchell absolutely crushed the pre-draft process.
He did.
So, in this mock, Mitchell goes to the Jags at 12 after a trade-up. Boy, I hope we didn't give up 48 to make that happen, right? Like, are you giving up 48 to go get one of these two corners? You giving up one? I'm not.
No.
I'm just not, man. It's got to be another corner other than these two that's worthy of starting consideration. And maybe I take him at 48. But I'm not giving up both of those picks to move up five spots. I don't believe. At least, if they do it, I'll understand it. They're trying to express the courage of their convictions that they believe in Mitchell or Arnold, or maybe it's one of these offensive linemen. But for me, I think that's a pretty steep price to pay. So Arnold goes next to the Raiders. Tali Fuanga goes to the Saints. Byron Murphy goes to the Colts, and Troy Faletanu goes to the Seahawks in this mock. So the Jags, if they had stayed put, could have had Olu Fashanu, or Fashanu, as I've heard it's pronounced, the Penn State tackle. Would you rather have Fashanu and whatever you gave up to go get Quinyon Mitchell, or would you rather have Quinyon Mitchell? I'd have to know what I gave up to get him, I think.
I don't think it would be the second-round pick in that. I don't think. That's what it would call. I think
not.
It would be a third and maybe something in the future.
I still don't love it, but I get getting your guy, you know, and I think most Jaguar fans, and I kind of projecting this on them, but based on what kind of feedback we got, if they got day one starters at 17 and 48, and you got a guy at 96 that projected down the line like he will be, you know, and then you get an interesting prospect or two after that. I don't think most people are expecting starters from the fourth round on, right? You get guys that you hope one day maybe one or two of them will develop into that. But, boy, if you gave up 48 to move up and get one guy.
That'd be a lot.
That's a lot of pressure on that one guy.
That's
guy, you better damn well hit that pick.
Especially if you're talking about, you know, trying to get to 12, 13, you know, in that kind of range.
Right, and we're not talking about going up. And I could see Jag fans, and again, I can't speak for you. I'm going to try based on the feedback we get, that I think if you made that move and you got Malik Nabers or Roma Dunze, all right, okay.
Yeah.
We're giving Trevor his guy. This is his guy that he's going to grow with, using air quotes.
And everyone's already gone through whatever the mental math is of, okay, it'll cost what to get to 8 or 9 and get one of those guys?
And,
okay.
And it's for them. Yeah. You move up to get the corner when you could sit there and maybe, and I understand in this mock it went Mitchell and Terry and Arnold, but you don't know that.
Yeah.
The Raiders may take quarterback there. They may trade back knowing they can get Michael Penix later, or feeling they can get Michael Penix later in the first round and still get that fifth-year option on him. I don't believe that one of those two corners will be there for the Jags, but I'm not willing to give up the 48th pick to assure that I get one.
I think that'd be a big overpay. I'm looking at the draft value chart right now.
Where's 48 get you? 9?
48, let's see. 48 is, 400 points basically from where they are. That would get them to... 8, 9.
It's like 9 with like a 7th rounder coming back your way, right? So let's say it was 9, right?
Yeah.
You're okay trading a 9 to get Rome Odunze, right?
Yep.
What if Odunze's at 12? Would you still give the same compensation? You'd be okay with that?
No.
Really?
Well, at 12, I'd be wondering what's going on with him. But yeah, maybe, I'd be willing to make a move for Odunze. I'd be surprised if he's still
I understand,
there.
But if you're mentally willing.
Yeah.
To say I'm going to give 1 and 2, 17 and 48, to go up and get a Odunze, and I'll get like a late round pick back in the deal. And it just so happens now that you're getting him at 12 instead of 9. You're actually paying him less, right, a little bit. And I get it. The chart will say you're giving up too much, but it's what you are willing to pay to get the player.
It's where you value the player.
I don't hate that much if it's for that guy. If it's for corner or I don't know.
Yeah, you look at corner specifically, right? Say it's 13 with Vegas. The difference between the two picks is around 200 points.
Okay, what is that, like a fourth?
Right, so you look at the Jags' second round pick, it's 420 points this year. Right, like that's a big overpay. The third round pick, that compensatory pick, 116.
Wow.
Right? So
that ain't worth much.
No. And so then if you combine that with the fourth round pick, which was worth 62 on the chart I'm looking at here, now you're getting to around that number.
Roughly, but you still got to throw.
You're still about
20
points short.
So you got to pay your third, your fourth, and maybe a seventh or something like that.
You'd have to throw in, let's see, what would get you about 20 points here from the Jags? 20-point pick would be top of the sixth round.
Okay, so let's say you had a pick there. Now you're talking about not only those picks, because you're giving up 17 as well.
Yep.
Are you giving up 17, 96, 114, and a pick in the sixth round to make sure you get Quinyon Mitchell?
That's a lot.
Are you doing that?
That's a lot. I probably wouldn't do that. But again,
hey, Terry, and you're looking good, buddy. Yeah. You're really the apple of our eye.
Yeah, and look, I think, as we've discussed, if one of those corners are available and the Jags are on the clock at 17, I'm running the pickup in all likelihood.
Sure.
Right? But if it's... Well, he might be coming down to us. Do we need to make a move? My answer is probably no.
Right. And you know? If it is, and you can do it for like one of those fourths.
That's
right.
Different.
That's right. If we're talking about – and like the Giants did, fifth and a seventh to move up one spot. If he gets one or two spots away, I find it hard to believe you're going to get that deal, you know, done with Indianapolis because they might be taking them themselves, especially, you know, after things fell through on trying to trade for an elite corner with L'Jarius Sneed going to Tennessee this offseason.
Yeah.
But I don't know, man. A lot of scenarios, a lot of different ways it could play out. And I'm probably – like, I get it. If you really got one of those superstar wide receivers and you felt like the pairing of Lawrence and that guy is going to be kind of the face of your passing game for the next 10 years, hopefully.
Mm-hmm. I get it.
I get that more than I get – like, we may end up – are we still paying Tyson Campbell a boatload of money, right? Like, are we going to really give up a first, third, fourth, and sixth rounder to get one corner? That corner's bust too, by the way. You know what I mean? Like,
yes,
that's a lot. I'd rather – in that case, I get it. You want the elite player, and this roster doesn't have room for just an unlimited amount of rookies to join it.
Right.
But wait, you see what happened. We did that deal last year to move back. Giants come up, get Deontay Banks. Jags get the fifth and the seventh. Well, all those picks aren't going to hit. You hit on the fifth, you missed on the seventh. Boom. Okay, you got a starter out of that deal. The other guy you cut, and you're like, so who cares, right? It's like it's a free roll, free spin at that point. All right, I got to take a timeout here. We are live. The Coastal Equipment Guggen Open, just an absolutely spectacular day. Tony, if you've seen a cloud, that's the first one either one of us have seen today.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just gorgeous out here at Hidden Hills. So if you're not playing today, hopefully you make plans to play in the 2025 Guggen Open. But we're having a good time out here today. We'll have Helmets and Heels and the entire broadcast crew all afternoon long out here on Monument Road. Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, and Dylan Denmark here with you. We're halfway home. More Jaguars Today straight ahead on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today.
From the JOI Studios at 1010XL.
This is the playmaker, Michael Irvin.
I'm Ken Wisenhunt.
I'm Paul Spicer.
And you are listening to 1010XL.
1010XL.
Big 1010XL.
92.5 FM.
I'm here with Clayton Bromberg of Underwoods. Let's talk a little bit about guarantees and warranties and what they mean. I've heard you say that Underwoods guarantees the price paid on a diamond solitaire if you trade it in for a larger diamond later on, and that you give a 5-year warranty on a Rolex belt from Underwoods. Just how do you monitor all of that?
David, I think before you can talk about a guarantee or a warranty, you have to first look at a company's history of how they've treated customers in the past and how long they've been in business. Because a warranty or a guarantee is really nothing more than the word of a company. Their history and reputation will give you a good indication of how they stand behind their products. As far as how all this gets monitored, a lot of companies give you something in writing, and if you lose it, well, then you don't have a guarantee anymore. At Underwoods, we keep up with the price paid and the date of purchase, so if a customer loses their receipt, we've captured all the information and can retrieve it for them. I guess simply stated, at Underwoods, our guarantees and warranties are our word, and since 1928, that's been the most sacred thing we have to offer.
Underwood Jewelers.
Brian and Angela Wall here with Window World. You've heard us talk about it. Window World, the number one window replacement company in the USA, selling over 1 million windows each year for the past 8 years.
That's a lot of satisfied customers and why J.D. Powers has awarded Window World best in customer satisfaction 3 out of 4 years.
Window World stands behind their slogan, simply the best for less. With Window World, you get top quality windows at a price that leaves more of your money in your bank account, and you get the absolute best guarantee there is in the window replacement industry. When compared to our competition, there is none. See for yourself. Call the competition. Get quotes from them. But before you buy, get Window World's free estimate and compare the quality of the windows and the price.
You'll see.
And when your new Window World windows are installed and they're saving you money on your energy bills, if anything goes wrong with those windows, Window World and I will be there to make it right. That's my guarantee.
Call Window World today. Start saving money on your new windows and your energy bills and take vacation with your savings. Window World, online at windowworldneflorida.com.
Window World, simply the best for less. Thank you for your business.
Window World also offers energy-efficient doors and siding.
RJ Saunders here, sports lovers. I recently took a tip from Frank Frangie when I needed to send flowers to my mother. Frank told me that Kuhn Flowers is the only florist he ever uses. So that's what I do now. I use Kuhn Flowers. Find them online at kuhnflowers.com.
Home of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Dave Binion here with my son Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes, your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're a clean air specialist.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
Z-E-R-O-R-E-C. Zero Res.
This is Hayes Carlion for Skylife Elite. Have you ever thought about aircraft ownership as another potential revenue stream and as a tool for tax savings? Put your tax money to work for you while enjoying the benefits of private personal travel. SkyLife Elite has over a decade of experience in business aviation and can guide you through the process with their expert staff. Call my friends over at SkyLife Elite at 490-9332 or find them at flyskylife.com to get the rundown on everything owning an airplane can do for you.
There are three certainties in life: death, taxes, and if you stay in your home long enough, a new roof. Pick it here for our friends at Lockhart Roofing. Nobody better in Jacksonville. How do I know? They are a local certified Master Elite contractor, and that means they have a GAF Master Elite warranty. That's the best in the roofing industry. In this day and age, don't settle for cheaper discount roofers. Lockhart Roofing has been here for decades. They aren't going anywhere. Call my friends at Lockhart Roofing, 994-3851. That's 994-3851. Lockhart Roofing, Jacksonville's best for Jacksonville people.
If you owe the IRS and can't pay, now is the time to call J. Divitt Tax Law.
After a two-year hiatus, the IRS has resumed their aggressive collections letters. Don't wait. Call J. David Tax Law or visit jdavidtaxlaw.com.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, brought to you by J. David Tax Law. The Gators dropped the weekend series to the South Carolina Gamecocks after losing both Friday and Saturday. The Gators, however, were able to salvage the weekend and gain some momentum with an 11-9 victory on Sunday, snapping a six-game losing streak. Head coach Kevin O'Sullivan spoke on the victory Sunday and what went right for the Gators.
At some point, we're going to snap the losing streak, and today was obviously the day we did it. We had some really good approaches at the plate. We went the other way, I think, four times in one inning, and guys had some really good approaches. We were trying to push the issue a little bit offensively. We put a couple double steals on, a couple hit and runs, and try to force the issue, but yeah, it's a big win.
The Jacksonville Icemen fall to the Gladiators last night 7-4. The Icemen open up the Kelly Cup playoffs on Thursday against the Florida Everblades at home. It's 79 degrees at 11 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Everything you need to know about the Jags. Jaguars today on 1010XL.
So the Jags offseason program starts today. Tony, I know Josh Allen and, you know, the little bit of stuff I kept up with. I was like in a news embargo, self-imposed, last week. But the little bit of stuff I kept up with seemed to indicate he'll be here. Try to
early on.
Right. Figure out what defense. His role is going to be, what's asked of him in the defense. And then he'll go about his business. Now, here's the thing. I don't think the Jags are like, okay, Josh, sign this. And he's like, oh, yeah. He signed it and goes, oh, by the way, I ain't going to be here for a lot of this stuff. I'm sure they were fully aware. And, you know, he credits his offseason preparation in part, you know, to a figuring it out last year. Like, everything all coming together at the same time that, you know, like people will look and say, hey, it's a contract year, but, you know, there's no – instruction manual for how to become a superstar in the National Football League. There are paths to follow and what have you. And then it's the work that he put in the offseason that enabled him to have that kind of year last year. So, look, if you think that Josh Allen is still going to be the highly motivated guy, I don't have a big problem with this. And I've always been – you and I think have always been on the side of the players get screwed in the CBA and the owners – will happily take advantage and press the issue, for instance, on the franchise tag when they've got that tool at their disposal and it may not be the best for the player, they'll use it. Why would it? Yeah. Sorry, it may not be best for you. This is, you know, there are two sides to
this.
We're
doing what's best for the team.
Players get an advantage of we don't have to be here for some of this non-mandatory stuff in the offseason. And if they don't show up for it, you know, like – it can't all be one-sided. It can't all be, well, you got to do everything you can. You know, you got to go above and beyond to win. Well, then why are we even negotiating this kind of stuff?
You're allowed to be upset at whatever players don't want to show up for the voluntary portion of the offseason, but you can't hold them accountable for it, right? It's voluntary.
Right. You can hold them mentally accountable if you want to, but there's not going to be, you know.
You can feel about it however you want to feel about it. And especially here in this first couple of weeks, I'm reading – Demetrius has an article up about, you know, the off-season program starting. And as he puts it, phase one consists of the first 2 weeks of the program with activities limited to meeting, strength and conditioning, and physical rehab.
Yeah, we're going to do a little – we're going to ease you in.
They're going to be
in
the building.
Do a little weightlifting.
Yeah.
You're going to be around. We're going to reacclimate ourselves. And I'm sure they're going to be soaking up a little knowledge, you know. Like if I'm – yeah, especially Josh Allen, right? If you know you're not going to be around, you want to get in Ryan Nielsen's – presence as much as possible, you know, and that you have that opportunity to understand what your role is and what's asked of you and all that. And let's be honest, at this stage, man, the people who do this are generally the star players.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, it's not like, you know, Yasir Abdullah is going to get away. It's not going to benefit his career. He could say, hey, CBA, right? I don't have to be here for that. Well,
yeah,
okay.
That's a bad choice.
That's dumb, right? That's pretty dumb, right? Josh,
it's one you're allowed to make, but it's one with real repercussions.
You absolutely have the right to make it, and I'm not going to fault you. You're willing to exercise it. I'm going to say you're probably using bad judgment on your part. I'm not going to say, ooh, bad person for doing it. I'm just going to be like, is that smart for you? You know, I'm not mad at you for doing it. I just, you know, doesn't make a whole lot of logical sense.
There are real potential consequences for a player of that status saying no. And for a guy like Josh Allen, if he says, look, I'll see you at OTAs, right? Like, if that's the way he handles it, then the team goes, yeah, we'll see you at OTAs.
Yeah, and we'll see you, and you'll hopefully and we're not giving you $150 million unless we think you're that guy.
Yeah.
Right? Which, by the way, I guess the $150 million was a little, like, sure, if you're, like, all-pro.
He hits all the incentives.
17
yeah.
and a half sacks every year. So, really, when you look at it like that, like, the incentives in Brian Burns' deal are more likely to be earned because he needs, like, to go to the Pro Bowl,
yeah,
right? Whereas Josh Allen needs to be like a All-Pro or a Pro Bowler and have 17 and a half sacks. Look at this guy. I mean, tee time was, I believe, 10-10 this morning. Not sure what you're planning on doing here.
I saw a couple of East swings this weekend. They weren't the best.
He looks like he may be looking to find some spare balls in the water hazard today, man. He's got those pants rolled up just a little bit. Come on, sit down here and say hello to your buddies, Mr. Emmanuel Thalerand, if you still consider his buddies. You're going to swing around to the backside here? Oh, you want to be on video. So you want proof that you're out here is what's going on. But anyway, you know, just to finish the thought on that.
Yeah.
They know who Josh Allen is. They're not giving that deal unless they think they know who he is. I don't think you're handing out $150 to anybody that you don't think is going to put team first and do whatever he needs. Now, scoot on in here. I'm not. I don't have the cooties, man. Come on. I might. But you know what? You should be used to them by now. That's my guy, E.T., right there. What's up, E?
What they do, my boy?
What's going on, man?
Man, you know, they say this golf outing. I'm like, man, you know, I'm working on the game.
Are you? What did you see, Tony, with E.T.? What swings did you see?
He had a – where were you?
I was at a yard.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
How's that, by the way?
The beer loop.
Is it nice out there?
It's beautiful out there.
Is it?
Yeah. Oh,
I've not
now
checked
it's,
out.
Like it's no. got it's got all the ET energy because the swings were not good, but the reactions were awesome.
Oh, I'm sure.
I gave up and I just started throwing a football with the kids.
Hey bro, you know what? You know what they say, swing hard, the ball might just get in the way of your club and it may go a long way. Oh, you know, if you swing easy, you know, even if you hit it well, you'll be like,
right,
nah.
right.
You know. Anyway.
What was going on with your little guy and the like, what was that swing?
YouTube.
Like that kid, was nuts.
Kid watching YouTube. So apparently there's this YouTuber out, and he swings with one arm. He rips it and he grips that thing. And
it's right-handed, Mike. I've never seen anything like it. It's a whole loop. Mm-hmm. He doesn't pull it back. He just loops
it
forward.
Just kind of swings it around,
yeah,
right?
Like a lasso.
It must be a popular thing because there's a guy at my driving range who does the same thing, and he hits it better. Yeah. I'm telling you, he's just starting out in golf, right?
Yeah.
And, like, I see him try to hit with a two-hand grip, and you're like every other golfer, and I see him going with one hand. I'm like, you're actually hitting it pretty good. Like, I've never seen anybody hit it that well just with one hand. Yeah. Like, anyway, so were you out here this morning, E?
No, not this morning.
You're back at World Headquarters today?
World Headquarters.
Oh, okay, so you're running the show over there.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
All right, I wasn't sure, you know, but we're happy that you – it wouldn't be the same without you out here.
You know what I'm saying? You know, I had to come do it.
You do look like a golfer. You know, you pull it off.
You look good, you feel good.
And, well, you fool them until you –
You fake it.
Right, you fake it. Exactly right. You fake it. Bro, I'm still doing it. I'm still faking it, and I've yet to make it. But, we're 10 days out. What would you like to see the Jags do at the 17th pick if you had your druthers?
I've been looking at some film. I've been doing some research.
Have you been breaking it down?
Yeah, I did a deep dive.
Good for you. All right, you'd be the first one.
And I'm starting to like Brian Thomas more.
Are you?
More.
You are, all right.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm just kind of settling. You know, Roma Dunze. I want a receiver.
I got no issues with Roma Dunze, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, if we got a reasonable path to getting there.
Are you saying you're off Cooper DeJean?
No, that's the second pick. Second pick.
Oh, that's are we moving up to get him, or is he going to fall to us?
I don't think he's going to fall to us.
I don't either.
From the sounds of it. But I like the kid as well, but I like that. With the seven, I'm just more focused
on the 17th
pick.
You just want that pass catcher.
I need a pass catcher, man.
He looks like he's the next guy in line, right? And I think there are a lot of scenarios, Tone, where he's available at 17. I mean, I think it's – honestly, I think it's more likely than not that he's available
yeah.
at
where
17.
Where does Brock Bowers rank as eligible pass catchers?
A lot of people like Brock Bowers, but we just signed Evan Engram. Like, if we go get Brock Bowers, then I don't want to go get a receiver early.
We signed Evan Engram, and we drafted a tight end in round two last year. It was Taylor Dahl, do you understand what the situation is here? Do you know who those flowers are for? They're for you. Oh, you do know they're for you. Okay. Well, of course they're for me. I get showered with flowers on a daily basis. What, are you kidding me?
Right. We're going to read that note together.
Of course they're for me. There's no question. I don't know who they're for. I don't even know that they're for you other than I heard Dan and Jeff said that they were for you.
They're nice, though.
Someone delivered Taylor Dahl a dozen red roses. And this is not like the, hey, it's been great working with you. No. I just wanted to recognize. This is like the romantic gesture dozen.
That's like, hey, big head.
Hey, girl.
That's up? That's what them flowers mean.
See, that Taylor's like, all right. I'm just thinking, there's like, I don't know. I don't even want to say because I don't even want to say. You know what? This is way out of my field of expertise at this point in time. But they look very nice, and you're deserving. Someone should be bringing you a dozen every day. I'll just say that. You know what? You know, so E.T., get on that, please. That'd be good. Taylor and the ladies of Helmets and Heels coming up at noon today. They've been doing an outstanding job. Happy to have them following us on the new lineup. We like to keep things fresh around here.
We
E.T.
do. You know what I'm saying?
Mix it up a little bit. You
absolutely.
Know? A little Brian Thomas action, you know, maybe.
What y'all thinking with the 17th?
I'm the same way. Like, bro, I heard your guy this morning, Jeff Prosser. You know, I used to be your guy. But now Jeff. But anyway, I heard him say he didn't like the idea of the trade back. And I'm like, Tony and I are like, man, you're going to have like eight guys that you're going to be happy with that 17th pick. And I get the idea of if you got one that you love, mm-hmm. right? And
I would love
fine.
To be able to trade back because there's eight guys I
right.
would like.
Yeah, right. For us. Right. Right? And we look at last year, you know, they moved back one spot, right? The Giants move up, got Deontay Banks. Jags got a fifth and a seventh, all right? The seventh was Derek Parrish. Waste, nothing, right? Trash. The fifth is Antonio Johnson. Okay, so they got a starter for moving one spot, you know? And I don't know. I just think – now, granted, if one of those two corners is there and you're really – have your heart set on a corner.
That name,
or
yeah.
if Brian Thomas is your guy mm-hmm. and you feel like the drop-off to Adonai Mitchell or whoever is too big, that's mm-hmm. fine. I'm not going to have an issue. I'd have more of an issue if they made a move up, you know, unless, again, it's for a guy we want him to move up for. So, hey, man, I'm just happy it's 10 days away.
It is, man.
Right? Let's get some new blood in
yes,
here.
Yes, sir. Football season is almost amongst us. Let's get it, man.
Let's get it, baby. All right.
New logo or new throwback uniforms.
What's the deal on that? What have you heard?
This is what I think, because based off of the social media, I saw the old Jaguar logo.
Right.
And I think it's going to be like that old teal. That
you think they're going with the old full throwback uni?
Yeah.
Because the rumor had been that they're going to go with an alternate helmet this year.
I think they're going to hold uni.
If they do,
that's going to go crazy.
That'll be interesting. Now,
I wonder what players they'll make available in those unis.
Trevor.
Right?
Quarterback.
You mean when they model them?
Yeah.
Trayvon
Walker. Well,
Walker.
Not only that, but like.
Josh Allen.
Hey, 150.
Yeah.
Get over here.
Yeah.
This is
like,
the fine
three
right
print
there.
Right
here.
Yeah.
Like, it's hard to find, like, an old-school Fred Taylor jersey.
Yeah, no.
Right? And if they're going to wear the throwbacks this year, do they put a 28 out there?
Yeah.
You know? Like,
oh,
I
you mean
know.
The old ones?
Yeah. Like,
bring
how
back.
Much do they say, okay, now you can get a Bocelli jersey? Again, new. It's old, but it's new.
Right.
You know, like that kind of thing. I don't think there's a ton of players that you necessarily want that for, but
right.
there's a handful of them
absolutely.
That I think you could sell some jerseys mm-hmm. if you want to do it that way.
I don't doubt that for a second. So you think who are the three models, are you saying?
The model's going to be 16, 41, and Trayvon Walker, 44.
You think, I guess it is because he's like the new – I could see it being Kirk, though, because he's kind of Trev's guy,
okay.
right? He's kind of like his right-hand man, but – and you already – I don't know.
No Ingram love, huh?
Nope. Nope.
Hey, Kirk. Nope. I think they're both his. Obviously, they're both his guys. So anyway, it's great to see you as always.
Always a pleasure to be with.
Thanks
my
for classing it up out here. So what are you? Are you just like man about town rest of the day?
Yeah, I'm about to create some content. I might have I might have an adult beverage or two or six. We'll see.
Well, the content flows as the beer goes,
the
hen.
Hen
dog. The hen rolls. All right, our man Emmanuel Thalerant at IME to the T. I know you're already. Follow him out there on social media. All right, we got to take a time out here. ET's not going anywhere. We're at the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open. We're out here at Hidden Hills Golf Club, and we got just dozens and dozens of golfers out there on the course taking it in, and could not have had a better day for it. We'll be back. Tony will take us around the league when we return, and we've got another mock to dig into on the other side as well, Tone. And we'll do that straight ahead on Jaguars Today here on 1010XL and 92.5 FM. Hey, folks. Mike Dempsey here for Dandy Foods. Wanted to jump the gun because I'm very excited to be back in the seat talking about Dandy as you're driving around Duval right now. Maybe listening to Jaguars Today. You know, lunchtime is coming up for you. Well, you know there's going to be a gate station nearby. Maybe you'll need a little gas for your car's tank, but you probably need a little fuel for your belly as well. And that can come in the form of some local goodness. The Thompson family, a local family, started Dandy over 65 years ago. It's Dandy and the Anytime Deli labels. When you go into a gate station and head to the fresh case that you need to be looking for, they've got fantastic breakfast items, snack items, and yeah, a great lineup of classic sandwiches and subs for you. How about a hot roast beef and provolone? They got an Italian combo that'll melt in your mouth, an all white meat spicy buffalo chicken, of course the big old juicy 100% beef cheeseburger, all the classics. Those four served on fresh ciabatta bread, baked locally, delivered daily. As you'd expect from Dandy, when you're hungry, do what I do, go out and Makers of Dandy, do it today.
Jaguars Today.
From the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios.
J-O-I, where the pros go.
Estimated in 10 seconds.
Well, why don't you just turn it on and see what it does?
Our sports radio is 1010XL.
I knew it!
Hey everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Awaken 180 Weight Loss. Look, last week I recognized I had made a difference. No, it wasn't saving a puppy from a well or pulling an old lady out of a burning building. Remarkable as those would have been, this one was pretty cool as well. I saw a hacker and he was down 45 pounds thanks to Awaken 180, and it was awesome. Well, why was it awesome? Well, he thanked me for introducing him to Awaken 180. So I'm not only able to watch him have that same transformation that I had, but I know I had a bit part in helping someone make a 180 with their life, and it inspired me to continue sharing mine. From Matt Hayes to Hacker and hundreds of listeners, every story is uniquely inspiring. If you have questions, feel free to ask me about Awaken 180. I'm happy to answer all of them, and just maybe you will be the next Awaken 180 success story. Call Awaken 180 today at 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or schedule your consultation online at awaken180weightloss.com.
This is the sound of real people across Florida betting on sports. It's the sound of winning your bet only on Hard Rock Bet. And if your first bet doesn't win, you get up to $100 back to try again. Hard Rock Bet is Florida's only legal sports book. Your home for betting hoops for any sport you choose. Download Hard Rock Bet now and get two shots at your first bet. Win, or you'll get up to $100 back as a bonus bet. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 plus and physically present in Florida to play. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMIT-IT.
Have you been dreaming of enhancing your living space with top quality custom windows and doors? Well, now's the 30-day spring sale with Renewal by Anderson. Save $300 on every window, $825 on all patio doors. Plus, no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Renewal by Anderson, a better way to a better window. Visit rbafla.com.
License number CGC1527613.
Now that's what I call high quality H2O.
If you want high quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. Water Boy JAX.
Cross, I'm thinking about changing my name.
Again? You're already the media mogul, the straw that stirs the drink, the Duke of Pablo Bay. Now what?
Refer to me as Dreamfinders Danny Hicken.
What in the blazes? Is this a cash grab?
No, it's just that I believe so much in Dreamfinders Homes. 20 locations in Northeast Florida, official home builder of Jags and Gators. Great opportunity for first-time homeowners.
All right, Dreamfinders Danny it is.
Did I mention the lowest interest rates you can find? Visit DreamfindersHomes.com. Now let Dreamfinders Danny celebrate through the majesty of song. Dream finders,
oh,
I believe they will build your home just right.
I love the smell of fresh draft picks in the morning.
What are Jacksonville's draft day options?
Tell us what you're thinking for our first pick.
1010XL's draft coverage is brought to you by Renewal by Anderson Windows and Doors, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
We're in Florida, and pest problems are persistent. Want them gone?
mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions. Veteran and locally owned and operated, Mission Pest will blow your mind with their communication and response time for all your pest, termite, and mosquito needs. Text or call 904-944-PEST. You'll speak directly with the owners. Mention 1010XL when you call 944-PEST. You'll get 25% off your initial pest or termite protection service. Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions.
Hey there, Jacksonville. With scorching temperatures just around the corner, it's crucial to ensure your AC is blowing nice and cool. Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to keep you comfortable all summer long. But don't wait until the heat gets here. Our service techs are ready right now to handle any cooling issues you may have at your home or business. Call Duck Duck AC today at 904-862-6769 to schedule. That's 904-862-6769. Duck Duck Air Conditioning, online at duckduckac.com.
Sports fans, JJ LaSalva here. When I need to send my bride flowers or a plant for birthdays or anniversaries, I always go with Hume Flowers. After all, they've been the leading florist in these parts for over 75 years. You can always rely on Hume Flowers.
Homeowners and investors, the choice of title company is yours. When making that decision, choose the team of St. John's Title, LLC. As board-certified expert attorney-owned firm with decades of experience, we provide the utmost in precision and professionalism. Conveniently located offices and in-home remote closing options, we serve your needs. Whether refinancing or selling your property, our customer-first approach is tailor-made to your timeline. With a seasoned team of experts and five-star testimonials from customers across the First Coast, call or visit St. John's Title today.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Jaguars today
on 1010XL.
All right, we continue live here at the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open at Hidden Hills Golf Club with Ladies in Helmets and Heels coming up at noon today. Hey, Pockets, how we doing on the old media mock draft? Groundwork being laid for next week? What kind of stage are we in right now?
Yeah, the foundation's being laid right now. I just literally just texted JJ to see if we get somebody from the Chargers. So,
the Chargers.
We're working on it piece by piece.
All right. Should we have total confidence that we'll have all 16 of our guests lined up next Wednesday?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. That's all we need to hear.
This is the most pressure you face.
Dylan does a good job.
In your short time with us, Dylan. We love you, buddy, but this is it, bud.
Don't. You know what I'm about to say. You know what I want to say.
Say it.
Don't mess it up. Uh-huh. All right? That's not what I want to say. Mm-hmm. Anyway, don't. But here's
some other euphemism for mess it up.
Yeah, you know what it is. Next Wednesday, we will do this is one of the rare occasions when we have not covered. You know, Tony and I used to do the whole mock draft, right? We used to do it on a three-hour show.
We did.
Then one year we did it all in a two-hour show.
It was bananas.
32 picks, 32 correspondents, and we got them all in.
Hi.
Hey.
Who would you like to pick?
Who are you taking? No. Well, you know. No! Who are you taking? Click. All right, go. All right.
Get it.
So we decided we're going to share the wealth, mm-hmm. and we're doing it with the split it up with XL Primetime. Well, it just so happens, obviously, with the Jags picking 17, we're doing the first half. So as we end the show, the Jaguars will be on the clock next week. And I don't – look, far be it from me to – I have no idea what the Helmets and Heels crew is doing for mm-hmm. the Jaguars selection. I do know that we are bringing in Taylor Dahl.
Yes, we are.
To represent the Bears.
Both times.
Been a Bears fan for a while. Right, both times at 1-9. I think maybe they'd say, like, that Tony Smith guy, that Mike Dempsey guy, are on Jaguars today every day. But whatever, they do. So we're going to do that next week. We'll have a correspondent on Wednesday from every team. And it will, you know, it's a fun exercise, but don't take it that seriously because the whole thing breaks down. Once one pick goes awry and somebody is available. But it is always funny every year. There's somebody that slides in the mock draft, right?
Oh, for sure. And look, the year we did all 32 picks in the 2 hours, there was no time to talk about any of the needs any of the teams even had.
No.
Right? Like, we had time. Hi, this is X, Y, and Z from X, Y, and Z. Who do you like?
You're on the clock.
For the pick. You're on. What's the pick? Like, that's all we had time to do that year. And now we got it more spread out. We can at least ask everyone who comes on what's going on with the team.
Yeah.
You know, what do y'all look at as your needs? You know,
what's the likelihood you want to trade down?
Moving up or moving back, whatever it happens to be. Like, there's at least space to have a conversation about each of these teams on Media Mock Draft Day, and we've had to play it where we're doing the Speedy Gonzalez version where there's no time not to get into any of that. Yeah.
No, not anyway. That's next week. It'll be a blast. We always have a good time with that. It's like year 20 or something we've been doing.
We've been doing it a long,
long time. And then, of course, we'll be on Thursday and with the lead up to the real thing, at least the first round of the NFL draft spread out over several days. Other things going on around the National Football League. Let's find out about a few of them. Tony Smith takes us around the NFL.
Now, gems around the NFL, brought to you by Beaches Jewelry and Pawn in Jacks Beach.
The Philadelphia Eagles and wide receiver Devontae Smith have reportedly agreed to a 3-year, $75 million deal with $51 million in guaranteed money. Cincinnati wide receiver T. Higgins said at a youth football camp on Sunday that he does anticipate playing for the Bengals this season. The Bengals used the franchise tag on Higgins. He then requested to be traded shortly after that. No deal seems to be imminent. Higgins himself now alluding to yesterday when asked about it, saying that he does anticipate playing for the Bengals this year, and went on to discuss the love that he has developed for the city during his four seasons there. San Francisco wide receiver Brandon Ayuk's agent, Ryan Williams, with Athletes First, said on X on Sunday, quote, "You need better sources," to someone claiming that Ayuk has requested a trade from the 49ers. The last time we heard from the Niners, the owners' meetings were going on. They were saying that they were trying to work on a long-term deal with Ayuk. I'm sure that John Lynch will be asked about that situation again when the 49ers host their pre-draft media availability here in the next week. According to an arrest affidavit obtained by the Dallas Morning News, Kansas City wide receiver Rashee Rice was driving 119 miles an hour in a Lamborghini Urus before fleeing the scene of a six-car accident that was caused by Rice and SMU wide receiver Teddy Knox, who was driving a Corvette during the accident. The computer on the Corvette apparently registered him at 116 at one point in whatever lunacy they were doing on the road.
Apparently losing, because 116 ain't 119, Tony. Yeah, ain't going to get you the finish line.
Yeah.
So, and also risking losing your life.
Crazy.
Of course, and all, yeah, 119, man. And, you know, look, again, marijuana laws have changed a lot. I don't want anybody behind the wheel if they've been smoking it, though. Mm-hmm. And I can't – that's the thing. Can't prove that what he was doing because he fled the scene.
Yeah.
What's the – is there a charge for fleeing the scene of an accident among the eight charges?
I believe there should be.
You would think, right? I think it's leaving the scene of an accident with serious injuries or something like that. But – is that a lesser, if you're convicted of that, is that a lesser penalty than driving under the influence of something with significant injuries? You know what I mean?
So,
like, you're probably better off running in that case. Sorry, officers of the law, I take it back. but in his case, it looks like he's going to benefit from that. All right, CBS Sports latest mock, Jared Dubin does them, part of the rotation over there, put one out yesterday.
Dubin does them.
Dubin does it, Tony, and let's roll through it quickly here until we get to the Jags pick. And then I really want to focus on a little bit, we're talking about the trade down, the target-rich environment that they'll be in. Caleb Williams, USC quarterback to the Bears, Drake May. And the way he puts it, he goes, there's been a lot of smoke about Jaden Daniels, but May has long been considered the second-best quarterback in this class.
Okay.
I mean, maybe? I don't know. Like this, I feel like this is – there's been a lot of Jaden Daniels is going ahead of Drake May. This feels like I've seen a lot of mocks recently with May back in the two spot, and I feel like teams are trying to get the sense that that maybe is what Washington's going to do, so they're going to act like they knew this all along.
I would like your definition of the word long, please.
Right. I mean, Jaden Daniels just tore the SEC and college football a new one last year. And anyway, so he's got Daniels going third to New England. J.J. McCarthy, the Vikings trade up to get him at four, but then the Cardinals trade back up to five. And they've done something like this fairly recently, so that doesn't mean they're going to be able to do it again, by the way. But they move back up to five and take Marvin Harrison Jr.,
okay.
Malik Nabers, the LSU wide receiver to the Giants, Joe Alt to Tennessee, the tackle out of Notre Dame, Dallas Turner, the Alabama pass rusher, going to Atlanta, Roma Dunze going to the Bears. I mean, you can find that in a billion mocks, right?
Yep.
That same combo. Tali Fuongo to the Jets at 10. Okay.
Yep.
Then the Chargers, after trading back, taking Olu Fashanu, the offensive tackle out of Penn State. J.C. Latham. See, is he climbing, like, at least in pundits' eyes?
He's right there in that conversation among the top two, three.
Because, right there, and he's also, though, I see him still some places are like, a little heavy-footed, like you're going to see him in the mid-20s or something like that. Anyway, Latham goes to the Saints. Terrion Arnold goes to the Raiders at 13. The Saints had traded up in this a couple of spots. That's interesting. Traded up a couple spots to take Latham ahead of the Raiders, who take corner. And then the Broncos take the other corner in Quinyon Mitchell, which is interesting there. Mm-hmm. Cooper DeJean then to the Colts.
Ooh.
Right? So corner.
Yeah.
Jared Verse then off the board. So the Jags could have Brian Thomas if they want. They take Nate Wiggins. They take the fourth corner. I don't love it. I just don't love it. It's too skinny. For me, it may be great. I'm not a scout, but I want a corner that has eaten in the last week.
Yeah.
Byron Murphy. Here, all right. Wiggins. Would you rather have Wiggins or Byron Murphy?
Murphy.
I'll take Murphy. He goes after him. Wiggins or Brock Bowers?
Ooh.
That's tougher for me. I might go Wiggins, but I'd rather have corner than Brock Bowers, but maybe not Wiggins. Is that fair to say? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just don't love the idea of Wiggins. Amarius Mims out of Georgia or Wiggins? Who would you rather have? I could go either way there.
Yeah.
Depends on their evaluation. I mean, you got to be sure about him. Guys that get up in that 340, 350 range, I worry about getting sloppy.
Sure.
You know? What about Johnny Newton, the Illinois defensive tackle? Maybe not like slam dunk, right? Latu Latu.
Latu.
I know you love him, right? He's going 22nd. Brian Thomas goes 23rd in this after the Bills trade up to get him as he slides that far. Jackson Powers Johnson goes after that. Mm-hmm. Troy Faltanu. I'd rather have Troy Faltanu there.
Too.
And in this mock, he goes 25th, Tone. Grant Barton of Duke. I'd rather have him. I would. As long as you got a plan on where you're going to use him, right, on the offense, all these offensive linemen. So that's a bunch of guys that I'd
rather have.
Either rather or at least equally be just as excited about. Or I could trade back, and there's a pretty good dang chance that Nate Wiggins will still be sitting there when I trade back.
Mm-hmm.
On top of that, now you got to have a partner, obviously,
you do,
to get that done. But definitely interested. All right, let's come back and take a look at the Chad and Sandy Real Estate question of the day. We're at Hidden Hills. So we cleverly asked you today, what do you think will be a hidden strength of this Jacksonville Jaguar team in 2024? We'll look at some of your responses. And as we said earlier, it's hard to know what are going to be the obvious strengths of this football team. So the hidden strengths are a little bit more difficult to come up with, but we'll debate some of the various position groups when we return in the moment. Live at the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open out of Hidden Hills Golf Course out on Monument. Mike Dempsey and Tony Smith, Dylan Denmark back at World Headquarters. You're listening to Jaguars Today on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios, where Jaguars fans find common ground.
And we are Duval! Duval!
1010XL.
Hey, Glenn here with B&B Oil with Dylan from March Motor. Hey, Dylan, how does B&B Oil help you guys at the dealership?
If you have a dealership and don't want to worry about the hassle of credit cards or fuel vouchers floating around, have B&B Oil put a tank on your lot. It allows us to control who gets fuel and cuts out the worries of credit cards. And it helps us deliver the car faster. B&B Oil also meets our shop needs with lubricants as well. Call Glenn or check out the website, bb-oil.com.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
Denny Thompson here. Tackle burglars and protect your turf. Give yourself peace of mind catching everything around your home with Tyson Sound & Security's cutting-edge surveillance cameras. For safety and convenience, Tyson has you covered for all home cameras and security systems. I'm talking HD recording, night vision, and remote alerts all from your phone or computer. Call Tyson Sound & Security right now at 904-762-1000. Tyson Sound & Security, security and automation experts.
If you're searching for a new fence installation, challenge yourself to find a fence company with more positive online reviews than Superior Fence and Rail. With over 3,000 reviews and a 4.9 out of 5 review range, Superior Fence and Rail is well, superior. So take the online challenge or let their professional team show you what superior service looks like. Superior Fence and Rail, where quality matters.
SuperiorFenceandRail.com.
It's tune-up time, and Florida Home AC, the official AC partner of the Jaguars, wants to partner with you for a cool summer season. Tune up your AC unit right now so it's running at peak performance when you need it most. Just call 777-4300 and order a tune-up for just $59. Keep your unit humming at optimal level. Log on to floridahomeac.com and take advantage of their savings. Keep cool with Florida Home AC. That's 777-4300.
Hello. Every great call comes to you on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
Just pick up your telephone and dial.
Listen for great phone interviews all day on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
We'll talk on the phone.
On 1010XL. You're shriveling
up there. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball presented by FIS with tickets starting at just $5 is back at 1-to-1 Financial Ballpark this weekend. Don't miss Coors Light Thirsty Thursday, Fireworks Friday and Saturday, and Military Appreciation on Sunday Family Fun Day. Tickets start at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball. Affordable, family, fun.
Brian and Angela Wall here with Window World. By now, everyone has heard about saving money on their energy bills. There are all sorts of things you can do to cut energy costs, but most people don't think about their windows.
But Window World knows that the biggest energy loss in almost every home is the windows. There is more energy loss from old builder-grade windows than just about anything else in your home.
You can upgrade your heating and air, your appliances, that's good too. But before you do all that, upgrade your windows to Window World's energy-efficient windows.
Window World's windows are easy to clean, energy-efficient, and have the best guarantee in the business.
Window World's slogan is simply the best for less, and we mean it. You get great American-made windows, and you get to keep more of your money when you buy from Window World. Need any more reasons to buy your windows from Window World? Call them today and set up your free in-home estimate or go online to windowworldneflorida.com.
Window World, simply the best for less.
Thank you for your business.
Window World also offers energy-efficient doors.
Have you tried golfing at the improved Cimarron Golf Club? If you haven't, tell you what, you're missing out on the best deal in Jacksonville. Now, many of you have received a postcard in the mail, and of course, if you bring that with you, $45 plus tax to play. That includes a cart, lunch, and a beer at the brand new Stone Barrel Tap House. Now, go to the website, that is CimarronGolfClub.com, and sign up for the Wild One Loyalty Program. That's the Wild One Loyalty Program, and get all of these specials emailed to you from Cimarron.
Keeping your body healthy and active leads to a more vibrant life. A great place to do that is the First Coast YMCA. The Y is equipped with state-of-the-art cardio and strength equipment, plus group exercise studios where trainers host activities like yoga, Zumba, and cycling sessions. The full-court basketball gym and indoor five-lane swimming pool are open year-round. The Kids Zone can keep an eye on your kids while you work on that dad bod. And it's all available with your family membership. Learn more at fcymca.org.
What Major League Baseball player has drawn the most walks during his career? The answer next.
How long has it been since you compared homeowners insurance rates? Log on to southernoak.com to get an instant quote or find an agent near you.
Our family protecting yours, Southern Oak Insurance.
Barry Bonds holds the record for most career walks, being given first base over 2,500 times.
Southern Oak Insurance, our family protecting yours.
Yo, this is Tony from Tony D's. Are you looking for a great slice of pizza? Well, we have about 12 varieties. Most places won't have slices of pizza after lunch. At Tony D's, you can get a slice all day. It's always fresh at Tony D's Pizza. Bay Meadows and 295.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. This is Jaguars Today on 1010XL.
All right, finishing up this morning out at Hidden Hills Golf Club on Monument, the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open underway. Tony, I see no ambulances come through, so we haven't had any major accidents out here. We're hanging in there.
Yeah.
As of noon, not even halfway through 1010 tee off. As I wonder if you can figure out why that would be. If you can't, well,
welcome to the show.
Welcome to the program. Yes, I was gonna say I was gonna insult another program, and I wasn't sure which one to insult. Was the thing I was gonna say? Maybe you should be listening to this, and then I'm not gonna do that, Tony. I turn over a new leaf. I'm back off a 2-day vacation.
Yeah,
and I've turned over a new leaf.
I'm glad to hear.
I'm gonna be a team player.
All right,
going forward here.
I'm looking forward to seeing what that looks like.
Yeah, me too. Not sure how that's all gonna work. All right, today we. Are asking you, seeing as we're at Hidden Hills, for a hidden strength for the Jacksonville Jaguars for 2024. What do you see as being a hidden strength for this football team?
Whew, yeah, it's as we discussed right off the top of the show, I don't think it's easy to pinpoint
the obvious.
You know, one obvious thing. I land on.
Does that make every strength potentially a hidden strength then?
I don't know.
I think tight end, they're going to be good, right? Like, right. I can't say you're hidden when you had 114 catches from your lead
guy. I think
guy.
It's hard to point to a position and say that's the strength of the football team.
Yeah.
I think it's more what it points to. Hidden strength, I would say I would land on linebacker.
Okay.
Inside linebacker specifically. They were willing to do the deal with Foye to keep him here. He's played at a Pro Bowl level through 2 years. They were willing to invest the first round pick in Devin, right? They keep addressing the depth at that spot.
Is Devin Lloyd an inside linebacker anymore?
Yes and no. You know, it depends on how they want to play it going into the year, but yeah, like – yeah,
I mean, I think he's a starting linebacker.
Like, when they're more in that 4-3 look, then, yeah, he'll be the strong side, I would guess.
Okay. I'm going to say, for me, and this is projecting a little bit here, and some have said, I'm going to say safety.
Safety was on the short list for me.
Like a linebacker, if you go linebacker in general, I'll say okay. If you're saying inside linebacker, I think they're playing more of a four-man front. So, to me, Foye Oluokun is – as consistent a player practically as they've had in the last couple of years, right? So I don't look at that. I wouldn't say that is hidden as much for me. But Andre Sisco hasn't fully bloomed, right, at this point in time into what we hope he will be. Could he be more of a disruptive playmaker this year? I think he could. Antonio Johnson, we've just scratched the surface of what this guy can be. And I think, you know, Tony, again, you go back. A year ago, if Antonio Johnson goes in the middle of the second round, no one is saying boo about it.
No.
Right? I mean, he was projected in plenty of mocks in the top 50 picks that I can recall that we looked at. And, you know, guys fall for different reasons. We're happy to have him. And then you bring in Darnell Savage, who, granted, is going to be your nickel, but he's kind of like a big nickel kind of safety type guy, and you've got good depth there, I think, as well. It's one of the real
best. Thomas and Wingard. Yeah.
I think Thomas and Wingard give you some of the best depth that you have at any position on this football team, to the point where if it weren't for the fact that you got some young guys that really haven't shown you what they're going to do yet, I wouldn't even say that this is necessarily that hidden of
a
strength.
I think, you know, Daniel Thomas has been so good on
special teams.
But how much is that going to be affected by the new kickoff rules? Right? Like, I'm not saying he can't play on kickoffs, but I don't know what bodies they're going to be putting on kickoffs now. Specifically punts, I think he's still going to be Daniel Thomas. He's going to give you that. Like, that doesn't affect that role at all for the football team. But I do wonder on kickoff coverage and return, you know, is Daniel Thomas the guy that's going to be playing? You know, what does core four special teams even mean? You know, with the kickoff being changed this year in the NFL, you know, teams have to figure out exactly what that's going to look
like. How many
guys
are playing all those teams?
Right.
Now.
Yeah. And you only have, you know, your 47, 48 guys that are active. You know, like, you're still limited in the number of guys that you're going to have available to you to figure out what the answers to any of this is going to look like. But what kind of plan you're going to have for dealing with that, I think it is one of the big curiosities going into this season. How teams want to deal with special teams now that kickoffs have changed.
Why don't we look at what some of our listeners submitted in terms of hidden strengths. Your guy, Demetrius Harvey, that name sounds familiar. Anyway, I've been gone too long. Big Meech. He said linebacker as well.
Okay.
So you're in good company right there. So I can't really fault you if Demetrius is going to give you the seal of
approval. You and me,
Meech. The two of you. Dr. Cliffy goes tight end room as a whole. Got Evan Engram at the top. Yeah. Brenton Strange and others can contribute in two tight end sets. We'll allow much more balanced approach to the offense. And, of course, when we have Brock Bowers, it'll really look, if they draft Brock Bowers, it better not damn well be a hidden strength.
It better be a strength.
It better be a leading strength of this football team. Will anybody – I haven't really looked through everything. Will anyone say quarterback as a hidden strength? I would hope, again, we got Trevor Lawrence. We got maybe – one of the top two or three backups in the league in Mac Jones. Mm-hmm. And as of now, we got a veteran in Beathard who they've been content to roll with for a couple of years.
Yeah.
You know, it better not be a hidden strength, I hope. Jay Villain-Daniel went kickoff defense and return game. I don't know if he's being facetious or not. I really don't know. You know, like, I don't know how you're, you know, unless you're just leaning in on, you know, Heath Farwell or somebody, you know, thinking that this is going to lead to great things. And then he said, hashtag Jaguars today, not Jaguars today. Apparently he spelled with the extra A earlier. Interior defensive line, Cristiano. Again, if I'm listing obvious strengths, that's close to number one potentially for me with Eric Armstead coming in. And I, granted, again, maybe it shouldn't be. Devon Hamilton disappointed last year.
Right. It's how big of a question is the rest of it.
That's fair.
Behind Armstead.
Now, if you go out and you draft a D-tackle in the first two rounds.
Sure.
Again, that should be probably considered maybe the strength of your defense if it goes that way. Wide receiver room, already underestimated in my opinion. Said Duval Mobb, I expect a standout year from everyone catching balls in Jacksonville this year. I can get behind that. But spend the 17th pick on Brian Thomas. And should we say that's, you know, a hidden strength of this team, right?
Right.
It better be a strength if you get first-round wide receiver, if it goes that way. Christian Kirk, spent the money on Gabe Davis. Zay Jones been here. That should be a strength to your football team.
I would think so.
Secondary is a rock, said Big Will. The big nickel package and the position flexibility to allow for more pass rush, confusion to allow more turnovers. Be a top-five unit in the NFL. I'll take that. The throwback uniforms guarantee a W, said Adam. All right. Running back, got from several people. ETN top eight in the league and Tank a top 30 running back, all assuming our O-line
Let's hope.
A little push. That's from Andrew. Kickoff return. Again, Duvernay has been an all-pro. Shouldn't be a hidden strength. The return game should be a strength of the football team,
I think,
that guy. Offensive line. Now, that, Tony, if it TFS Godfather, if that's a strength of the team, that's a great answer, right? Mm-hmm. I don't think anybody's looking at this going, oh. They're like, really? Like, a lot of people are like, they're just running it back. Well, you got a new center.
They do.
So at least you can't, you don't have that to go, oh, if they're just rolling Fortner out there, they're not trying. Well, they're trying, okay? So they got a center. We'll see how it plays out with the rest of the line, you know?
Yeah, I was just thinking with the listener that seems to be the champion of the Brock Bowers fan base among Jaguars fans here.
Got a couple. But
you know, if they were to draft Brock Bowers in the first round, when's the last time an NFL team had two first-round tight ends on their roster?
Gronk was the second, right?
Yeah.
Because
Ingram was a top 10 pick.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, like you talk about investing in a position, you know, from a football team.
Right.
Like that
two
would just
first and
be,
a second?
Yeah. Like crazy investment.
Two for, even though you didn't spend the first on Ingram, you gave him big
He's
money.
He's a first-round pick.
First-round pick. Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure we could probably – what probably happened is somebody probably had a tight end that they drafted in the first round that wasn't – like Hayden Hurst, right?
Yeah.
Like maybe Hayden Hurst played on a team and –
played with some team that had used
that had
the
used
the
number one pick on
point,
a tight end,
but it would take something like that,
right? Like Hunter Henry.
I don't think I can't think of a circumstance where a team had a player at the quality of an Evan Engram and spent a first round pick on a tight end.
Certainly not one coming off that kind of season.
Yeah.
Right.
Not that I wouldn't be willing to do it, but it is. Different.
I'd be less inclined. Like I'm open to whatever, man. I'm not saying I've got the answer. You know what? There's a path where they draft Brock Bowers, and you're like, damn, man, Doug Peterson's back calling plays, and we're rocking the hell out of this two tight end set.
Mm-hmm.
And it's fantastic, right? I'm not saying it's impossible for it to go that way. I'm just trying to play the odds and what I think is more likely. What do we get here? Got a lot of tight end here. Slot corner with a flat, effectively more three safety formations. True, with Savage in the slot. Several people mentioned Doug Peterson calling plays. That play calling will be, once again, a hidden strength of this football team. Let's hope that's the case. Center from JagFan 15. Got a top 15 to 25 guy now. So let's see if that's the case. And a top 36 guy. Oh, that's great. I don't think that's what they were hoping to draft in Luke Fortner. But all right, you know
what?
We got one of the best backup center options in the league, Tony. How many people have a center, backup center, that started 32 games?
Probably not many people. Name another backup center.
Do long snappers count?
I don't think so.
Okay, well, they're kind of centers.
They're kind of center. They do snap the ball.
By the way, I couldn't name too many long snappers either, yeah. So I wouldn't be able to help you on that. I was just trying to stall. We're out of here in 1 minute, Tony. Yeah. If I could stretch this out, we'll pass this along to Helmets and Heels and let them figure it out from here, which is what we kind of do anyway, right? We stall until noon, and then you get the goodies coming your way. Best dressed team. Hashtag throwback from Flix Von Ulm.
Okay.
Uniforms. By the way, shout out Irish Jag. Our man Stevie.
Oh, yeah, that's awesome.
Going to be making a pick for the Jags. Sorry, Stevie, we waited to the very end of the program. Hopefully you're listening on the pod. He's cursing us in a brogue right now. But that's all. He'll get to announce
Stevie,
a Jaguar pick.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to drop the Go JJs.
Go JJs. It'd be great if he did it just for tradition's sake, though. Will he go dressed as that clown – with the Jaguar face paint, you know the guy.
Gosh, I hope
that
not.
That fool over there. Sorry, fool, if you're listening.
Captain Jaguar. Or
whatever.
Something.
But good job there, Irish. When you got Irish Jaguar as your social media handle, and you're making a pick from Ireland, I'd say that's the guy to go.
I trust Stevie will actually give us a Duval when he's on the microphone.
Oh hell yeah, and a well rehearsed one. He's one of our guys from the International Jaguar Mafia. All right, that'll do it for us today. We'll have plenty of draft talk as the week and a half plays out until next Thursday, and then it's reaction time after that. But good to be back in the saddle with you, Tony Smith. Couldn't pick a better day for it for the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open. So keep it right here for the ladies of Helmets and Heels as I see them getting ready to sit in our perch. You can watch them on the YouTube channel as well, and we appreciate all of you for tuning in, for our man Dylan Denmark, ET, for stopping by. All the folks like Gibby and everybody who engineer these things so we can just show up, plop our butt down in the chair, and run our mouths. We appreciate you guys as well. Jack O'Brien, Ken Brady, the sales staff, everybody puts on these events. So there's a lot of behind the scenes that go into these things. So it's great to be able to interact with some of our sponsors and our listeners, and I know we had some listener giveaways for this Guggen Open this year, so that's a lot of fun as well. Hit them straight, hit them well. Enjoy this beautiful weather. We're going to get another great week of it, man.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be fantastic. For Tony Smith, I'm Mike Dempsey. We'll be back at World Headquarters again tomorrow. Stick around for Helmets and Heels coming up next from noon to 2 right here on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
Jaguars today from the JOI Studios at 1010XL.
We found the computer outlet, sir.
Plug in.
No.